students, I hope you all are fine. So welcome back to our EVS session. And as you all know, in the previous session we had done the book work of chapter number 13. As our chapter number 13 is going on, that is World of Flowers. So today we are going to start with the notebook work. So all you have to do is you have to keep your notebook with you and all the stationery items. And you all have to write the question answers and keywords all with me. So as we are following the criteria, like firstly we will do keywords, then very short question answers, then short question answers. So in this session, we will be doing keywords, very short, and one short question answers we will be doing. Okay, so everyone just open your notebooks and start writing with me. So your writing should be neat and clean. Write down the date. Write down the date at the, yes, here right hand side, and here you will write the classwork. At the left hand side, you will write the classwork. Is it clear? So date is the 8th of October 2020. And here you will write the classwork and make the heading of lesson number 13, World of Flowers. World of Flowers, and also you have to make a heading of keywords because we are doing firstly keywords. So everyone, just write it in your beautiful handwriting. So here is the first keyword. First keyword is stock. First keyword is stock. S-T-A-L-K, stock. So what is the meaning of stalk? Stalk is a long or thinnest part of the plant. Just pe flower grow kar rahe hain ya koi bhi cheez grow kar rahe hain. So fruit grow kar rahe hain. So stalk is a very thinnest and long part of a plant. That is a stalk. Okay. This is the first keyword, stalk. Then next is swollen. Swollen, S-W-O-L-L-E-N, swollen. Now, what is the meaning of swollen? Swollen means thicker or wider than usual. Koi bhi cheez, agar if something is in the shape this and it becomes this, it means it becomes thinner. It becomes thinner than usual. Jo pehle thi usse zyada phool gayi hai. That is meaning of swollen. That is the swollen. Now next is bloom. Bloom. Bloom means to produce a flower. Koi flower grow hua hai, flower bloom hua hai, that is the produce flower. That is the meaning of bloom. Next is attractive. A-T-T-R-A-C-T-I-V-E, attractive. So what is the meaning of attractive? Attractive means that pleases or interests you. You like which thing you like. Aapko jo cheez pasand hai, usme aapka interest jayega, and you are just focusing on that thing. It means that thing is very attractive for you because you like that, right? So this is the meaning of attractive. Now next is germinate. Next is germinate. So what is the meaning of germinate? This word is used for seed. This word is used for seed, and it means to start growing. That seed is start growing. So this is the meaning of germinate. That seed is start growing. Okay. Let's revise again these five, then I will move forward. So first is the stalk, swollen, bloom, attractive, and germinate. Let's move on to the next one, that is sixth is bear. It is a bear, yes. You remember it is also very big animal, big and very thick animal. It is also, its meaning also like to be able to accept and deal with something unpleasant. Like if anything is happening around you which is very unpleasant, but you have to deal with that, right? You have to deal with that. It means you are bearing, like if you are in some very severe pain and you have to deal with that, but there is no any other option, it means you are bearing that pain. आप उस पेन को सहन कर रहे हैं. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ बेयर. ओके, ऑल्सो इट इज अ एनिमल नेम ऑल्सो, राइट? इट इज अ एनिमल ऑल्सो, बट इट्स नेम, इट्स मीनिंग ऑल्सो डिफरेंट फॉर सम टाइम. लाइक फॉर वी आर सेइंग समथिंग हैपनिंग अनप्लेजेंट एंड वी हैव टू डील विद दैट, दैट इज अ बेयर. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज पर्टिकुलर. Okay, what is the meaning of particular? Particular means if we are talking about something, if we are talking about only one thing or only one person, this is the meaning of particular. If we are talking about only one thing, like I am talking about here each and every word. So this time I have talked about stock only, then I talked about swollen only. So like this, if I am focusing on one thing and I am just talking about that thing only, right? So this is the meaning of particular. Now next is grave. Okay, so grave, G-R-A-V-E, grave. Now what is the meaning of grave? See, grave is a place where dead body is buried. Where dead body is buried, jahan buried means dafnana, means unko jameen ke andar dafnaya jata, that is the grave. So grave means where dead body is, it is a place where dead body is buried. Okay, jalaya jata hai, sometime it ko dafnaya bhi jata. Okay, so next is bouquet. Yeah, when we are writing it, spelling is different, but when we are pronouncing it, it is different. So in writing you will write B-O-U-Q-U-E-T, but in its pronunciation is bouquet. Its pronunciation is bouquet. Okay, so what is the meaning of bouquet? Bouquet is like a it is a bunch of flowers which is arranged very beautifully. And okay, so this is the meaning of bouquet, a bunch of flowers which is arranged very beautifully and attractively. Now next, 10th is, this is the last one. Okay, now next is import. Import means I-M-P-O-R-T. Yeah. So import means a thing which is just which brought from brought into the one country from another. Ek country se hum, like all of the material in India were coming from China, right? So that is, that process is the import. Import ho raha hai hamara jo bhi material aa raha hai India mein China se, right? To wo import ho raha hai. हमारे पास आ रहा है, इम्पोर्ट हो रहा है. ओके, सो ब्रॉट लेके आना, दैट इज द इम्पोर्ट. सो दीज आर द 10 कीवर्ड्स. लेट्स रिवाइज इट क्विकली. स्टॉक, स्वॉलन, ब्लूम, अट्रैक्टिव, जर्मिनेट, बेयर, पर्टिकुलर, ग्रेव, बके एंड इम्पोर्ट. सो दीज आर द 10 कीवर्ड्स. नाउ वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द वेरी शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन आंसर. सो एवरीवन जस्ट मेक अ हैडिंग ऑफ वेरी शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन आंसर. Very short question answer. So here write question number one. So question number one is, who sells flowers in the market? Who sells flowers in the market. Okay, tell me who sells flowers in the market? Market mein flowers kaun sell karta hai? Who sells flowers in the market? Yes, florist sells flowers in the market. So everyone write here, florist, F-L-O-R-I-S-T, florist sells flowers in the market. Florist sells flowers in the market. Okay? Now question number two is, name two plants that do not have bright colors or fragrant flowers. So they don't have any color, they don't have any bright color. Two plants are there. They don't have any bright color or any type of fragrance. Okay, so we have to tell the two names of those plants. So as I told you about the grass and weed, these are the two plants that do not have bright colors. Grass and weed plant do not have bright colors or fragrant flowers. So this was the question number two, name two plants that do not have bright colors or fragrant flowers. Grass and weed plants do not have bright colors or fragrant flowers. Okay, write it quickly, giving you few seconds to write it, then we will be starting with the short question answer. Okay, so I hope this is done. Now let's start with the short question answer. Everyone just make a heading of short question answer. And today we will be doing only one short question answer. And there are three short question answers and two long question answers. Okay. So question number first is, name four flowering plants. Name four flowering plants. हमें ऐसे plants के name बताने हैं जिन पे flowers grow होते हैं. Okay, so you all of you know many of the plants. You can write any one from them, but here I am writing some names. So you can just copy out and add on something. So four flowering plants are dahlia, D-A-H-L-I-A, dahlia. Then write rose, jasmine, Pansy, Marigold, Sunflower, etc. You can write any four. Okay? You can write any four flowering plants here. So these were some question answers and keywords of the chapter number 13, and tomorrow we will be completing this chapter. On Thursday this chapter will be completed, and your homework is to learn lesson number 12 full. Okay, and I will be circulating the date of mock test soon. This is your homework. You have to learn lesson number 12 full and you have to write it in your notebook, and bookwork should be complete. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye and take care.